The verse I quoted at the beginning of this lecture is in Surah 23, verse 3. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. The Surah is called Al-Mu'minun. Naturally, the Quran is an index for me. When I open the first page of the Quran, I'm looking at the index. I see a Surah called Al-Kafirun. I don't want to be with them. I see a Surah called Al-Munafiqun. I do not want to be with them. But I see a Surah called Al-Mu'minun. I say, I want to be with them. Let me see what the criteria is for a mu'min. Notice Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first criteria He gives for a mu'min is what? قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Successful are the believers. أَلَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Those who achieve a level of concentration and humility in their salah. Notice Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't say those who pray. Every Tom, Dick and Harry can pray. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, no, those who achieve concentration to a level it brings them humility in their prayer. Even those of you who've read the dua after Salat al-Asr, many of us read the dua, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min nafsi la tashba, wa min qalbi la yakhsha, wa min ilmi la yanfa, wa min salati la turfa. Ya Allah, I seek refuge from you from a prayer that doesn't raise me. I don't want to pray a normal prayer. Anyone can pray a normal prayer. I want to pray a salah, salah turfa. Turfa means what? Means something which is raised. I want a salah that actually raises me. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam used to always state, as-salah mi'raj al-mu'min. Salah is the mi'raj of the mu'min. We know that on the night of Mi'raj, the Holy Prophet, he went to the highest of the heavens and above. When he said, Salah is your Mi'raj, what did he mean? He meant the same stations I sought to reach on that night, your Salah should take you near those stations as well. But we find a problem because we feel when we look in the mirror that none of our Salahs take us anywhere near there. The reality is 3-4 minutes and we want to finish them as soon as possible and get on with our life. There aren't many of us who could actually say that our salah, we have reached moments in our salah where we reach the highest levels. And that's why you find the scholars of spirituality divide those who pray into four. They say the first group are those who are negligent of the laws of salah. They make many mistakes in their salah. The second are those who shaitan whispers in their ears throughout salah that if you ask them at the end of a salah, did you really understand what you were doing? He'll say, to tell you the truth, I just went through it as quickly as I can. The third are those who strive to a level where what? Where they are able to overcome shaitan for most of their salah. Maybe if their salah is 5 minutes long, like Salat al-Fajr, they are able to overcome shaitan for 4 minutes out of the five. The highest level are those who shaitan does not come near in their salah. That they reach a level where they see Allah before their salah, they see Allah during their salah, and they see Allah after their salah. When the scholars looked at these four, what did they say? They said the first of these groups are punishable. The second of them are accountable. The third of them are striving towards Allah. The fourth of them are godly human beings on earth. Therefore, when we come tonight to examine how Amir al-Mu'mineen reached a level of concentration in his salah, the title of our analysis is, what are the techniques we can learn which helped Amir al-Mu'mineen achieve concentration in his salah? Hopefully these techniques, if we begin from Fajr tonight, you will see a change in your salah as it helped me in a change in my own salah. Let's examine. You find that within the stages, number one, how important is our attitude when it comes to concentration in salah? Number two, how important is it that we know the benefits of salah? Number three, how important are the timings of salah to our concentration? Number four, what was the appetizer before salah that Ahlul Bayt focused on, that their Shia are lazy on, and that Imam Ali was struck in? This fourth area is a unique area which we need to come to in a minute. Number five, how do I stand in salah and how does it affect my salah? And number six, how important is it that I actually recognize that someone is responding to my words in salah. When you go through these stages, you'll find why Amir al-Mu'mineen's greatest moment came in his salah. Hey dar, 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 hey d